All right, back with another video. I know it's been a little bit, but you know, let's see, where do we leave off? It was my wife's birthday. We enjoyed a steak. So good, delicious mac and cheese. She got the chicken mac and cheese. One thing though, you know, I take her out for this fancy meal, and we get up to go. Doesn't she leave the chicken there? She didn't finish her meal. You know, I cleaned to the bone, as you can see, but she left her chicken there, the main course meal. She ate her mac and cheese and she was stuffed. I can't believe she left the chicken. I thought she left a little bit of mac and cheese and I was like, it's all right, baby. But nah, she left the main course, the chicken, the meat. But she enjoyed her birthday. Took the kids out to play for a little bit. Even though it's getting colder, they still need a little bit of fresh air. Because if you don't know by now, kids at this age need to be out and active. Like, Monty is a beast. Like, he has this little bouncy ball, like one of them little kangaroo things. Boop, 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 boop. If I don't let him go outside, he'll sit in the living room and bounce on that thing all day, just bouncing, because he's got so much energy that he's got to let out. So, yeah, I take him out, let him enjoy himself. It's crazy, because when they're inside, they bug the mess out of each other and start fighting about any little thing. He looked at me funny, but when they're outside, they play together so nicely. It's like, I don't know what fresh air does to them, but it brings peace to my heart. Because inside, I don't even want to be around them because it's like, argh. My mom had some more free time. So she was like, hey, I could watch the kids if you guys want to go out. Because I took the day off for her birthday. That's how we were able to go get that chicken she left at the restaurant. But then later that night, we went out on another hot date. And look at her. Look at her get up. Man, she looks good. Look at them heels. Oh, she's stunting. She's stunting. We got to the restaurant. She fell. She shot right back up. She didn't even think I tried to help her. But she got up so fast that I couldn't even touch her. It was like, boom. And her little poncho thing, he just, like, she took off like Batman. She fell hard. And she, I'm fine. She just kept it trucking. She fell so hard though, like her foot just went that way, and down goes Tiffany, up goes Tiffany, but it was good. We had like, we never went to this restaurant before. It was good. I was like, you all right, baby? You hurting? You feeling any pain? She said, no, I'm good. The next day, oh my shoulder. I'm like, see what happened? That age catch up with you. Now you see what I'm talking about. I always tell her, wait till you get my age, even though we're the same age, but I'm still older. Had a good time. And then it was my pumpkin's birthday.
How old are you?
Eight.
The big
go back up and close the gate.
Big eight, huh?
I'm taller than her now.
I don't know, mom's.
I'm taller than her.
We'll show them later once I get ready.
No, I'm taller than her. I said I'm taller than.
Let me see your hair. Turn around. Go back a little farther, closer to the door.
Do a spin,
pumpkin. Do a spin. Wait, don't mess up your hair.
I did a spin. I did my thing. That's what I had to do.
Oh, my Atlantis, eight.
You are fabulous.
What is that?
Look at you all dolled up on a little shopping spree for your birthday. Ooh, sucky, sucky.
Just spoiled her. Let her work a half day. Let her go to school for a half a day so she can enjoy a little bit of her birthday. You know, she had cupcakes and stuff, and she had to stunt her her birthday sash and Barbie gear at school, but she was going to have cheer practice that day too, so it wasn't like she was going to really be able to enjoy her birthday. So Tiffany and I took her out on a little shopping spree, let her get a little something for her birthday, and took her out to eat.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Oh my Lantis, you're 8.
Happy birthday.
So are you practicing?
Another person needs to be right here.
Oh, like mommy?
Mommy,
come on, help her be a bass. All right.
Not like this.
Oh. Oh, there you
go. Mommy!
You can't just let go. Gee. All right. Let's go get ready for cheerleading. For some reason, all I want to do is rake leaves. I don't know why. Probably because I can't ride my bike because it's too cold. But all I want to do is rake leaves. Is that weird? Or what? Last year I left a whole pile right here. And it just, I don't know. These are probably, some of these leaves are from last year. I don't know. But that's all I want to do. Rake leaves. Something to do before Malia has cheerleading. I'm gonna get a tarp, drag them all up front. And it seems like they're never ending. They just keep coming. I need a bigger tarp. I thought it was bigger too. You got it?
Yeah.
All right. Let's go. Okay. All right, you stay on the sidewalk, okay? Stay over there. So I don't want no car to hit you.
Why
is it
like
this? Huh? Because someone will come get it. You ready to help me, Matt? All right, grab the back end. Yeah. You got it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got it.
Are you clumsy?
Yeah.
You keep falling? Stay over here. Because they come suck them up. We gotta take Sissy to practice, I think. Yeah, let's go get ready to take Sissy to practice. So we finally took her to practice. This is my first time like seeing, I'm used to seeing the same old cheers all the time. I did not know they were gonna be throwing people up in the air. They really be throwing people up in the air. I'm gonna show you only snippets right here. This is only a little preview. At the end, I'm gonna show you the competition, okay? And yeah, so.
just dropped Malia off at Cheerzone. I think that's what it's called. Drove all the way out to Londonville. Dropped her off. Now getting the fam ready. Matt's back there with his bulldog shirt on. And we are going to go represent and support Pumpkin for first cheer competition. All right. We'll see you there. At cheer competition had my heart like pounding. If you didn't notice in the beginning right there how you see her zone out in the crowd and like, wow, this is a lot of people. And then when she made eye contact with me and that smile was priceless. Like, you can't beat that. Like, as a kid, seeing that you have someone there to support you means the world to them. And I saw that in her eyes when she laid eyes on me. But when she laid eyes on me, it seemed like she had a sigh of relief, but my heart was pumping. Like, my adrenaline was like, I was so anxious and anxiety, I guess, feelings I never felt before. It was like, I couldn't breathe. I felt like I wasn't breathing the whole routine. You think Sissy did on cheerleading?
I think she did a good job.
She did a good job?
Yeah.
Was there a lot of people watching?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was super nervous.
My heart was bouncing a little bit.
Your heart was bouncing?
Yeah, a little bit. But I was not
moving.
But she did.
Yeah, she did.
I can't get to it.
Pumpkin, you okay? All right.
My coach was crying, and she knew it was Abby.
Emotional?
Yeah, she knew it was Abby Hall.
What did you say? It was a heartbreaking moment?
Yeah.
A heartbreaking moment?
But you guys still have your party and stuff, so you can see everybody at the party.
What party?
You guys have your dinner next week.
I do.
So you guys get to see everybody. Today.
I was so proud of her. I'm like, wow, putting in work in... I don't even know, but at home, it seems like she gives up so quickly. But when she's cheerleading, she did not give up one bit. The teachers, when I went to the parent-teacher conference, all she kept saying was, Malia has perseverance. She struggles with some things, but she does not give up. I don't know if it's because we her parents and she shows her weakness to us, but when she's out and about, perseverance. She is strong and doesn't give up, and she knocked it out the park. She scared me at first because I was looking for her in her spot. She wasn't there, and I'm like, where'd she go? Did she get lost in the crowd? She found her way back, but she made it. She did good. Go Pumpkin. Good job. Daddy's proud of you. I hope you know that. You can tell it zonked her out. She passed out. Then later that night, Mama Bear and Pumpkin went out shopping, and me and Mott had some man time just chilling by the fire. Can't beat it. Super peaceful.
Uh-oh. There's a cat.
Then came the banquet. I don't even know why. I got so emotional. Like, I wanted to cry. I don't know why. Is it because my baby girl growing up, she's 8? She got the secret weapon award. She got a secret weapon plate. She is the secret weapon. All right? And I'm like, my baby is secret weapon. I don't know. I don't know why I got so emotional. But I held it. I held it together because I'm a man. But inside I was crying. I felt like I was crying for some reason. I don't know. But if you guys enjoyed this video, I know I've been not consistent, but it's okay. I'm enjoying making them like this for now. But be there for your kids, okay? Because it's something special. That's all I got. Now that all the sports are done, Madden's done with football, Malia's done with cheerleading, we could have our weekends back. Just wait until next year, though. Baby boy Mott is going to be playing football, Malia cheerleading, Madden's last year. He's going to be a senior. Yeah. So next year is going to be like... Stay tuned. Other than that, though, thanks for watching. And I'm going to say it one more time. Other than that, over and out.